A world-class education is closer than you think. How far you go has nothing to do with how far you go. Launch your career closer to home. Take your next step at cbu.ca.
There's something about this place. Brings me back, it always brings me back. This kind of love won't change. Brings me back, it always brings me back.
Start an adventure like no other and discover a path of scenic surroundings and world-class education. You don't have to go far to go far. Take your next step at Cape Breton University. Visit cbu.ca.
Discover an ocean of possibilities at Cape Breton University. Turn your diploma into a degree with over 20 programs and 60 areas of study to choose from. Explore fields such as engineering, business, and education that offer opportunities for real-world research and paid co-op work placements. Gain a world-class education and form lifelong friendships on Canada's most beautiful island. Take your next step at Cape Breton University.
Thank you. Hello and welcome to game 17 of the 40th annual Coalbowl Classic. We have the Breton Education Center girls versus the Hants East Rural High girls.
We have a good one today with Tuesday afternoon. Hants East beat the Beck Bears girls team by 10 points, 66 to 56.
So close one, though. Close one, right to the end.
Right to them. Here we go. Hants East wins the tip. Casey. Gatto for three. Just off. Burke with the rebound. Stays the Bears ball. Hurley looks to set up the offense here. Get something going for the Bears early. Hurley, Ross. McDonald, back into Burke. Burke out, McDonald. McDonald drives, blocked. Ross with the rebound. McDonald into Burke. Burke just off. Tough finish. Good contest by Hants East. Hopewell up to Gatto. Tip by McDonald. Hopewell for three. Just off. Hurley with the rebound. Hurley looks to push the floor. Hurley, McKinnon. McKinnon inside to Ross. Ross down low to McDonald. McDonald fouled going to the line. Fouls on number two, Jay Gatto. McDonald at the line shooting two for the Bears. I think that's huge for them early, getting to the line.
Yeah.
Using their size especially. They came out with a big lineup today.
Yeah, it's a different lineup. You know, senior night for
senior
the Bears
Senior night,
here.
I think. Yeah, exactly.
Couple, most of their grade 12s on the floor.
Yeah, exactly. McKinnon with the steal. Hurley, pickpocket. Folley pushes it, turnover. Ross, another turnover, Folley with the steal. Up to Gatto. Gatto with the finish. Nice.
She was solid last game.
She was.
All game.
I think it was 24 she had.
Yeah, probably the player of the game for me.
Yeah. Folley, I love Folley though. I think that's, yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's how you pronounce it. She played a great game the other day. Controlled the floor overall.
Good shooter.
She's a great defender too. Hopefully she can limit the turnovers today and play a great game again. McDonald with the missed layup there. And fouls on 24 Ross for the Bears. Reaching foul. Folley with a full court pass to Gatto. Gatto, cross court pass, just off. Gatto with the rebound, gets blocked by Ross.
A little bit of a press here for the Bears, it seems.
Yeah, it looks like it. Forced and turnovers.
A bit of replay here on the
here's the,
light, the outlet. Oh.
A steal by Ross, and then another steal.
Back and forth.
Then the
wide open layup,
yes. Bears look to push it. Hurley gets the paint. Burke, McDonald from three. Bang!
Big shot. Stretching the floor early.
Stretching the floor. You like to see. Love to see it. Another steal for the Bears. They're all over the
press
Tigers with this press. Yes, exactly. Get them what they want. Burke, 45. Out to, just not paying attention there. Floater gets it to go. Casey with the floater there. Hurley looks to set up the offense. Hurley, McDonald at the 45. Donald inside of McKinnon. Just gets tipped.
Good defense.
Yeah, get in the passing lanes. That was Ashton with the tip there. Number four, Chris McNeil coming in for Paige Ross here. Looking for a little bit more guard play there.
Yeah. Smaller lineup,
but still got three bigs on the floor. McNeil, corner, brings it out Hurley. Hurley from three, just off. Burke with the rebound. Nice follow-up for Burke.
Solid pass,
yes. Oh, wow. uncharacteristic. Just not paying attention there.
Didn't see what happened.
Turnover from Hopewell. Just stepped over the line, passed it in.
Yeah.
Unlucky. Not good. McKinnon inbounds. McDonald up top. McDonald looks to go inside of McNeil. Not there. Fowley. Fowley looks to break the press. Ashton.
It looked like a travel there.
Looked like a travel. I agree. Bears are all over them. Fowley with the full court pass to Gatto. Gatto pump fake. Nice take. And the finish. And one. That was nice.
Good take.
What a take. A little pump fake. Get him in the air. Drive baseline. Get the contact. Finish through contact. Get it to go.
That's how Hansey's got to attack this game. Yep. Just get out quick.
Get out quick, and especially with Bears press.
They can beat the ball.
Gets it to go. What a take. Get it out quick, for sure. I agree. Hurley. McKinnon. To Hurley. Careless pass there. Gatto with the steal. Fowley.
In transition.
Ooh. From three, just off. Ashton with the rebound, puts it up, gets blocked, out to, I think that's Hopewell. Yeah. Hopewell with the finish over top. Nice pass by Ashton. McNeil looks to run the offense here. Neil and the Burke, finish, just off, I like it though. McDonald with the follow-up, nice finish.
Another good pass.
Another good pass, yes.
They all count.
Full court pass to Fowley, they're just... Gatto with the finish. This is a cherry pick. Looks like they're trying to cherry pick here.
Three possessions in a row. She's
the back
of
the press is just being really weak right now.
Now checking their shoulders.
Yeah.
Wide open every time.
It's there every time. Hurley. Hurley. Jump ball. Great defense by the Tigers. Stays Bears ball, but Casey forced the jump ball there. The Bears' Zucker was pretty weak over there, I must say.
Yeah, I think they need to pick it
Can't
up.
Can't hear it.
Hansey's been better so far this
boys
game.
Boys team over there. McDonald inside, just off. Casey Ashton with the rebound. Fowley looks to push it out, running. Fowley. Over top. Nice finish. She's great.
She's good.
Yeah.
She's solid this game.
Solid. Hurley. Hurley looks to get inside to Burke. Burke, one dribble. Gets the foul. Way to attack the paint.
Loud atmosphere so far here.
Yeah. Here's the outlet pass there from Fowley to Gatto.
Just nobody back.
Yeah, back of the press got to be more aware of that.
Nobody
just got to drop. Nobody home, exactly. Nice pass, nice finish.
Can't
Burke
get the
can't get the yeah, can't get the first one to go.
4-point lead for Hants East. Still a back and forth game so far.
I like what the Bears are trying to do though. They're trying to get inside to their two bigs with Burke and McDonald. Burke turned around there, one dribble, got the foul, got one to go.
I like the press so far because if they can stay on Gatto, then they'll be fine because they're doing well up top.
That same thing that happened the other day. She got out running behind.
Yeah.
Fouls there on, was it Addison McDonald?
Yeah.
Fouls on Addison McDonald, first personal foul. It's three team fouls for them already, though.
Yeah.
Early.
No, you want
Hopewell.
To see.
Fowley. Fowley from deep. Just off. McNeil with the rebound.
Got to find a range first.
Yeah.
First
exactly.
Shot.
Get comfortable. It's first quarter. McNeil. Outlet it to McDonald. McDonald inside. I like the idea. Just wasn't there.
You can see it. You can see it.
Fowley. Fowley looks to get it running. Fowley. Hopewell. Hopewell just off. Ash with the rebound out to Gatto. Gatto looks to drive.
Good defense.
Good defense by the two bigs inside. McNeil looks to break the press. The Tigers are coming out with the press here too, huh?
It's more of a just pick somebody up and run with them up the floor. Not much of an organized press. Might just be getting a little bit frustrated.
Great nine. And a cop coming in for Emily Burke. Looking to go small here.
Yeah.
Which is okay. Tigers don't got a lot of size on the floor right now. See how this goes. Hurley up top. Hurley into Kopp. Kopp to McNeil. McNeil looks to find something. Shot clock violation. Good defense by the Tigers. It looked like Luke McKinnon in the stands wanted a foul.
Yeah, don't trust that guy with anything.
No. Number 16, Marin Quinn, coming into the game. Fowley just drives, gets out running, and finishes over top. Tigers with the turnover there.
Luke McKinnon still complaining about
is
the call.
Morgan Hillier, I see walking in the gym right now. Full nursing outfit.
Looks like it is.
With the Beck Bear soccer jacket on. Looking great.
It's what the young ones like to call drip.
Drip, yes, yes. McNeil looks to get something, brings it out top. Hurley from deep. Hurley just off. McNeil rebound over top. Nice floater. Great follow-up. Way to get in there. Get that rebound, put it up. Folley looks to break the pass. Full court pass to Ashton. Ashton Gatto. Gatto just
like
off.
A foul there.
Might have been a foul. Goes Bears ball off of the Tigers. Now I'm starting to hear the Zoo Crew.
Yeah, we're starting to pick it up.
Good to see a good little crowd here in the gym. The right bleachers aren't full, but both the white bleachers and the left bleachers.
Can't see them on the video, but both these bleachers are filled.
Yeah, it's good to see. Valley, floater. Follows up her own rebound out to Gatto. Gatto from deep. Gatto from deep.
Ooh, big
nice
shot.
Three. Great shot. Valley followed up on her own rebound. Didn't give up on the play. It kicked out to Gatto. McNeil, Kopp. Kopp brings it out top. Hurley. Hurley looks to get side. Step back.
Oh.
Just off from the bank.
Don't you see that too often, trying to use the glass?
Yeah.
Don't know if it was intentional or not, but almost worked.
Fouls on. Not sure, but number 11, Abby McSween, subbing in for number 12, Ava McKinnon. Fowley with the floater off, but got her own rebound, kicked out. It's a deep three, man. Yeah, that's a couple feet behind the.
Good shot.
Good shot. Fouls there was on number 9 and a cop. Fowley from deep, just off. Tigers letting it fly early from the line.
Oh, good outlet pass.
Good outlet pass. Just ripped that ball over Hants. Hurley underneath. Finish. What a finish. Nice outlet pass and finish. Two great 11s there, that connection.
Yeah.
McDonald and Hurley, they got a solid grade 11 core there coming in next year. And McNeil's in grade 11 too.
Yep.
They're definitely young. Just a whole, not one grade 12 on the floor right now for the Bears. Grade 9 Anna Kopp and another grade 11 for Chris McNeil and grade 10 Abby McSween.
Got a replay here of the finish.
What a finish.
Up and under.
Yeah.
Little Euro
nice
step.
Little reverse.
It's been a 2-point game so far.
Yeah.
Hants East up 2. It's a lot of
tight
back and forth play.
Same as the first game. It was back and forth for the first half. Then the Tigers ended up pulling away in the second.
Yeah.
So hopefully Bears can stick with him, give us a good close game to call. I think that's Gatto. I think he's originally from New Waterford.
Yeah.
His daughter, I think her name is, I think she's hurt though.
Yeah.
No, Lily Gatto's her daughter. She hasn't played yet, but yeah. New Waterford native there.
You know, Joe, your dad is one of the main workers for Bell Line here, isn't he?
Yeah,
Bell Line. One of our silver sponsors here at the Coalbowl.
They've been doing it for years.
Yeah, big sponsor.
Big sponsor.
Helps out a lot here with the streaming and all the connections they have.
Exactly. Brings in. Always looking off the game in Coalbowl, you know?
Yep. Minute 56 here left in the first. Hopefully the Bears can turn this deficit into a lead.
Exactly. Nice for them to get one win over the week, you know?
Yep.
I'm not sure if they play another one. Do they play tomorrow or Saturday? I think this might be their last one. Yeah.
I know the
turnover
Memorial,
by the Tigers.
I know the Memorial Girls played Hants East yesterday.
They beat them pretty bad, but then again, Hants East doesn't have their full roster down here.
You can't really.
You never know.
Yeah,
Hansie definitely could have competed with them.
Yeah.
With their whole roster. Fowley looks to break the press. Quinn, back to Fowley, just a not thinking there. Back over call. Fally outlet to Quinn, and Quinn just turned and tried to give it back to Fally, but.
Yeah. That didn't work.
Yeah. Hurley. That was Ashton getting the lanes there. Waiting in the passing lanes. It's a huge, big first forced turnovers here early.
Yep.
Defense obviously translates into offense.
Yep. Got the turnover, but good recovery. Didn't let
and
get
a cop
out.
Poked it loose, but off of her, obviously. Fally once again tries to break the press, directing the offense. Wants that screen up. High screen, hall by. Another high ball screen, turns it away, another one. Hopewell.
Deflection.
Drives baseline, deflection off of McDonald, I think.
Yep.
Who plays after this?
I'm not even sure. Honestly, you can check the coalbowl website.
Yeah.
Anything you need to know about coalbowl.
Great website.
Coalbowl.ca.
Very high tech. Off from three, Gatto.
After this, Memorial High School and Montsate Sacramento.
Is that the Lynx?
Yeah.
That should be a solid game.
That should be a decent one.
And then the Bears play after that against Cole Harbor. Seth Colchester. My apologies. Hopo with the rebound. Ashton outlet to Casey. Gatto. Fally. Hopo with the finish. Nice. Over the top. Gets it in. Nice, great ball movement there.
Getting it through the middle.
Yeah. Swings it around, get in the middle, and finish over the top. McNeil. Man, Tigers all over the passing lanes. Gatto with the in the lane there, gets the tip. Nice finish over the top.
Yeah.
Kopp. Hurley. Back to Kopp. Kopp into McDonald. McDonald turn. Fouled.
It's worked when they got it down low, but they're not doing it a whole lot anymore. They're trying to work it around the perimeter, not really just get it off the drive when they're better off just getting an entry pass into the post.
I think the banquets tonight.
Yeah.
Pretty excited for that.
Some people are, some people aren't.
Some
no,
people,
it's
I
a,
agree.
It's a good thing for people when they
I don't know.
It's sometimes
good food.
Good. Food is good. KLC does put on. They put on a good show.
Some great apple pie last year. I remember that. Gatto, mid-range. Nice little jumper. Can't get it go. Ashton with the rebound. Ashton with another rebound. Just working. Casey out to Gatto. Fally. There goes the first quarter. Love to see the work ethic by Ashton at the end of that last minute or so there. End of the first here.
Yeah, and just on the banquet again. You know, it's something that not the player. It's not the most entertaining thing, but, you know, they got to have it.
Yeah.
It's something that the tournament does to keep people coming back.
Yeah, for sure. And nice to see everybody cleaned up and sharpened up, you know?
Yeah.
For the first time, like, a lot of the boys walking around in sweats, pants and stuff.
It's a good good presentation.
Exactly.
I wonder who's going to be hosting it, though. I forgot who hosted it last year.
KOC, isn't it?
Yeah, but the person that was talking the whole time.
Oh.
I know Lowell Cormier
talked
for a bit, but I don't really know who hosted the entire thing. I don't know if it was Darren.
I don't remember. Coalbowl concert was last night.
Yeah.
Some great performances from all teams.
It's always fun to have.
Did the Girl Tigers perform? I'm not sure.
I think we missed it.
I think we missed it.
We were
practicing
preparing.
Yeah. Seen the Beck Girls one.
Yeah.
Was it West Isle that played? No, that was South Colchester. South Colchester had a good one where they sang the coalbowls and all.
Yeah, that was a good one.
And West Isle did a great presentation for late Janet Morrison with Over Rainbow.
Yeah, it's always nice. Nice for the
And then we did the Masked Singer. I think we did a great job.
I think ours is solid.
Yeah, for sure.
But besides all that, we got a basketball game to commentate.
Exactly. In reffing today, we have Nick Morash, Tyler Masson, and sorry, I forgot his name.
So do I.
So do I.
I didn't know the other one, so.
Nick Morash, yeah. 20. Tyler Masson's a great ref.
Yeah, obviously.
Obviously.
Coach for the Bears, too.
He's a good ref, too, man. He is good.
PEI.
He refs a lot of our games.
He actually gave me $100 one time.
Yeah, that was pretty, cool.
Court shot and
yeah.
He wanted my gift card, so he gave me $100.
Exactly. That was awesome. Another back over call. Tigers just being careless with the ball.
You got to think the Bears are going to capitalize on one of these turnovers eventually.
Yeah, they got to turn these turnovers into scores for sure.
Yep.
McSween. Who's that? Quinn getting into the passing lane there. Kopp with the inbound. Looks like they're playing a 3-2 here. Casey with the steal. Casey looks to get it running. Casey spin. Not there. Quinn with the rebound. Not there. Is that Casey with another rebound?
Yeah.
Out there down, working low.
Had the layup, but Gatto decided to pass it up.
Yeah. Gatto turns it out. Hopewell. Hopewell. Looks to get inside. Gatto. Quinn. Quinn to Gatto. Hopewell pulls up just off. Another rebound. Quinn with the rebound. McDonald outlet pass. Oh, that was off.
Didn't know if she's seen somebody over there or not.
I think it was clear, but Morrison there.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
she might have been a little too short. A little too short for that pass.
Yeah.
Which is okay. You know. But McDonald.
Can't change height.
McDonald turned to, if they changed height, maybe it was a good pass.
Yeah.
Travel there. Good defense by McDonald. Yeah. Staying straight up. Acting like a wall down there.
Yeah.
Reminds me of a guy named Logan LeBlanc. Gets down there straight up and like a brick wall.
Yeah.
McSween looks to run the offense. He's got some nice shoes. Jordan, 20. I think they're 32s.
I got no clue.
McSween?
Yeah, there.
Yeah. Nice her older brother's shoes, actually.
Yeah.
Kopp inbounding. Kopp to Morrison. Very young lineup for the Bears here.
Yeah. I think only one grade 11.
Yeah, three grade 10s, one grade 9, and a grade 11.
Yeah.
Bears are young, man. They're going to have a couple of nice years in front of them.
Yeah.
I think they got a great year next year coming.
Both teams, guys and girls, have a good future.
Yeah, for sure. Young teams. Kopp out of the 45. Kopp looks to drive. Kopp step through. Blocked by Gatto. No, Hopewell, sorry. Kopp all over.
Travel
on Hopewell. Could have been a foul there.
Could have been a foul. That's what I was just about to say.
Yeah.
But, you know.
But I guess she was out of control, so you
gave her the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah. Kopp to Morrison. Pieces by Quinn. Keeps it. McSween. Hillier in the corner from deep. Off the side of the backboard.
It's a little bit off.
Rough one. It's okay.
Happens to everybody.
I did that yesterday.
Yeah, I didn't.
See, it was one of those shots that was too easy to make, you know?
Yeah.
I was too open and too close to net to make. Turnover there from Hopewell. Just, off target to Gatto.
Low scoring game so far.
Yep.
No team at 20
some good defense,
points yet.
Though. Good defense.
Yeah, good defense.
Boas, Bears sticking with them, 18 to 15. Man, got to take care of the ball. Here's Ashton. Ashton can't get it to go. Neither team can take the ball, care of the ball right now.
Mm,
turnovers all over the place.
Nope, not a foul.
No, just missed layup and went out of bounds off the Tigers. Bears ball. McSween. McSween to Morrison. Morrison turns. Morrison, pull up. It's a nice shot.
Can't
just
get
off.
Anything to fall here.
No.
Oh, the shot,
almost got the steal there. Gatto. Hopewell. Gatto. Gatto looks to get inside. Fouls on Kopp on the floor. No, they called two shots, was it? Not sure what the call was. Yeah. I guess it was on the gather.
Yeah.
Nice to get to the line. Just off for the first one. McDonald there, grade 11, probably debatably the best player.
One of the better players.
Yeah, great big.
Yep.
One of the better players in the Cape Breton League. Gatto gets the second to go. McSween looks to run the offense. McSween picks up the ball. Morrison. Back to McSween. McSween looks for something. Kopp. Kopp inside of McDonald. McDonald turns. Nice finish. Drop step. Floater. That was pretty. What a finish. Fowley. What was the call there out of bounds?
Yeah.
Great defense. Got the trap spot. Forced the turnover by Morrison and McSween. Look at this. I think it was Kopp. Kopp gets it inside to McDonald. Close. 1-2.
Drops the shoulder.
Yep. Pretty. McSween, turnover.
Coach.
Coach Matt.
Coach Hogan, not too happy with that one.
He's a great coach.
He's a good coach.
We had him as a soccer coach this season. He's fun. Fun guy. Taven Joe McCormick. Yep. Filey from three.
Just off. To go.
McDonald outlet to Hillier. Hillier looks to push it. Picks the ball up. They call it travel there. Yeah, I saw that. Lifted her pivot foot up. She looked to turn around, but picked up the wrong foot.
Yeah.
Unlucky. Comfy couch over there. I saw grandparents were on it the other day.
Yeah, they said it was good. They said that
good experience.
Actually, they didn't even win it. There was a really? So they as you know, they're buddies.
Blocked by McDonald.
They're buddies of teams. They were buddies of the St. Mary's team this year, and the coach won it. And nice enough for him, he invited them on the couch.
That's pretty cool,
yeah,
man.
Pretty cool.
Hopewell gets that one to go from the mid-range. Yeah, I like the new feature. It's cool.
Yeah, a lot of different things here this year in Coalbowl.
Yep. Changing it up. Kopp drives down the lane from... I can't get it to go. Nice shot.
Two subs.
Two
coming
subs
in
coming
in,
yeah.
Three.
Taylor Hurley, Addison Darlin, and Sydney Raycraft coming in for Addison McDonald. Anna Kopp and was it Claire Morrison? Yeah. Oh. I think so.
No. Ivy McSween.
Ivy McSween.
Yeah.
Morrison stays.
They're trying to organize their press, it looks like. 2-2-1.
Yeah. Looking to stay aggressive. Tigers break the press. Gatto. Gatto out to Hopewell. Hopewell spins. Gee, I like
foul.
That call. Just
legal screen?
Wasn't set. Went up, set the screen, wasn't set. Fouls on number 2, Jane Gatto. She's coming off. And that's, I think it's
that's
Casey.
That's her third foul.
Yeah. So that's Dylan Casey subbing in for Jane Gatto.
Three fouls on her. Not what you want
to
see,
best
really.
Player, too, debatably. She had a great game, player of the game the other night, other day. It's not what you wanted. Three fouls in the first half. You gotta take her off for a little bit. Too
probably
risky to leave her out there.
Quarter,
yeah.
I'd say.
Hurley steps out of bounds, driving baseline.
See that inside.
Nice little mid-range
right
floater.
Top. She's been solid this game. Hopewell is it?
Yep. She's having a good game. Nice
she's
little spin move there.
Players.
For sure. Valley, another one from the deep.
Oh.
Can't get it to go. Nice hustle play by Ashton there. Saves it from going out and gets it off of number six, Sophia Hillier. Valley. Cross court pass to Casey. Just over her, too high. Right through her hands, out of bounds. Hurley looks to set up the offense here. Hurley. Hillier. It's off of Hillier. Another turnover. Neither team can take the ball. Two turnovers back to back there.
Yeah.
Valley. Nice pass. Ashton. Can't get it a goal. What a pass by Valley.
Yeah, it's been
saved by Hopewell. Keeps it in. Valley from three. Another one. Bang! Nice shot.
Got
She's
it to go.
Playing a great game. Beautiful pass here.
Couldn't get her first few to fall, but she got the fall eventually. Kept shooting, didn't lose her confidence.
Yeah, exactly. Got to keep shooting. Got to think you're making every one. Darlin from deep, just off. Valley with the rebound. Valley looked to push. Ashton slows it down. Valley keeps it in. Valley cross. What a move. Takes it out. Casey. Hopewell into Quinn. Quinn drives middle. Casey. Bang. She called bank, you think?
Nah, not a chance.
Not a chance. No, I don't think
they
so.
They all count,
either.
Though.
They all count, exactly. Hurley. from three. Off the front rim. Two subs coming in for the Bears.
McNeil and Gillis, is
yeah.
it? Coming in for Morrison and Hillier.
Making a lot of subs early.
Yeah.
Which isn't bad. Keep him fresh for the second half.
You know, you want to give everybody a chance to play in Coalbowl. Don't want to just sit
Chris
there for the whole game.
Ooh, Hanties is
the three-pointer here
happy.
From Foley.
From deep, ooh, Toll looked to be on the line.
I'm not arguing it.
Hanties not happy about that last call, but Hopewell forced turnover. Hopewell all the way, can't get it to go. Raycraft, Hurley. Hurley looks to break the press. McNeil.
Oh.
Tally with the
Good
seal.
Defense.
Crowds are great.
Yeah, crowd
it's
is
great.
Great.
You know what? You know, like, it's good to see people coming out to watch the girls' games, too.
Yeah.
The game's definitely going in the right direction.
Yeah. Yeah.
For sure. And college women's basketball.
Yeah, you know, we've seen the good game.
A lot
the
of coverage
day.
On that. A lot of people watching that. They get almost as many streamers as the streams as the men's game, which is awesome.
The LSU and Iowa game. That
Caitlin
was
Clark had 41 in 12 or something, 12 sets.
Crazy stats.
She is really good. She can shoot from anywhere.
Yeah, and
Paige Buckers
yeah,
had 28.
That's going to be a good matchup, I think.
Paige Buckers and Caitlin Clark,
yeah.
I agree.
I think that's on the – I don't know if that's on the weekend or not. I feel like it is.
I'm not sure because I know the men's
know the
Final
men's
Fours
on Saturday.
This weekend.
Yeah.
I'm assuming both Final Fours will be this weekend.
Even though the men's Final Four is at 2 o'clock on Saturday, there's bigger games at 2 o'clock.
Bronze medal, or is it the finals?
The finals.
The
championship
at two.
Of Coalbowl is at two. So you can
Who
pick.
Who cares about
you can
this?
You can pick your game, but I know what I'm picking.
I'm picking the finals.
I'm picking the
Coalbowl
final.
Finals any day of the week.
You know, March Madness, that's still the final.
Yeah, still the final.
You can watch it on your phone. Put the Coalbowl on the big stream. Watch March Madness
exactly.
on your phone.
Yeah.
Get
the priorities
right.
Score once in a while.
Yeah.
I see the Horton boys down here joining the Beck Bear Zoo crew.
Like to see it. Like to see it.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Good to see. Who's in the men's Final Four there? Purdue, and I think it's
NC State.
NC State, Alabama, upstate. And UConn.
Yeah.
Zach Edey, Canadian.
Yeah.
He's
Canadian.
Great. And then UConn just dominated team battle. They're such a good team.
My favorite player, obviously, DJ Burns. You
DJ
know,
Burns,
you,
he's
you
a
cannot
beast.
Like him.
He is. He's a monster.
My player of the tournament so far, right now, honestly.
Honestly,
I think so. Him or Zach Edey.
And the run as 11 seed to get to the Final Four is ridiculous.
You know, Zach Edey, everybody knew what he was like.
Yeah. He's
no,
a national
nobody,
player
DJ,
of the year.
DJ Burns
last
came
year.
Out of nowhere.
Chance to be national player of the year again this year.
Yeah.
He's like, DJ Burns, how much do you think he weighs?
Big guy.
Yeah.
Big guy.
Big guy.
Can move, though. He
move,
can move.
Yeah.
But
and
all that,
pass.
we got to focus on the game.
We'll focus
hand.
On the game. More
yeah.
important thing on your hands right here.
Good tip there from Raycraft.
Yeah.
8-second violation.
Oh, wow. Right of the timeout there. Bears force exactly what they want, an 8-second violation. One of the best, like, nothing's better than forcing a 5-second violation.
8 seconds and 5-second violations, those are two best calls you can get. Because
you get the energy going and charge calls, you know.
Anything to do with shot clock. 8-second violation, 5-second violation, shot clock violation.
It shows you're playing defense the right way. Darlin, Raycraft drives baseline, looks for the reverse, blocked. Raycraft gets her own rebound. Gillis out for three, off. McNeil with the follow-up, just off.
Looks like they couldn't find her.
No.
Just wide open in the middle of the key.
No.
Still couldn't finish, but.
No. Hopewell, 45, turns it out. Hopewell with the pass. Falley.
The tip.
Falley turns out. Nice spin move.
Oh,
inside.
Good
not there.
Bit
She's
of a
forcing
force.
A little too much, yeah.
It was there, though.
Looking like me out there.
Yeah.
Hurley. Off. McNeil with another follow-up. Gillis. Just off. Back rim. Nice shot. Falley with a defensive rebound there. Crossover, looking to beat the press by her own. Is she a young guard? Because if she is, she can play for sure.
Yeah, I don't know.
Another offensive foul. These screens are second illegal screen of the game for the Tigers. Moving.
Yeah. I think that might be bonus.
No, not yet.
Next one.
A lot of turnovers here. Careless ones, too.
Really low scoring game.
Yeah. Great defense. See if the Bears can get back into this game here.
Yeah, cut down the lead before half. That's not going to help.
They might have to get McDonald back on the floor.
Yeah.
She really dominated when she was on. Here's Ross subbing in for Raycraft. Seemed to get a little bit of size here.
Yeah.
Quinn. Hopewell. Gets inside, Hopewell off. Quinn with the follow-up, fouled. Fouls on number four, Chris McNeil,
yeah,
I think.
Not too happy with that call,
no,
but.
Not at all. She thinks she got ball, I think.
I guess so.
Unlucky. Quinn at the line shooting too. Quinn hit, missed. So I would say every team in this tournament hates Tyler Grant.
How can you not?
Those crash cymbals, he doesn't stop with those.
I don't know who's giving them to Luke because they've got his hands all over.
Oh, Luke's over with them.
Yeah.
Quinn missed both. But another foul? Hopewell with the rebound. I missed that story. Hopewell with the rebound, gets it back up and gets fouled, shooting two.
But yeah, if you don't know what we're talking about with the crash cymbals, when the opposing team's shooting free throws, Tyler Grant gets those big crash cymbals, makes a whole lot of noise.
It's loud, man.
Yeah.
It bothers me sometimes.
Yeah.
Hopewell misses two. That's 0 for 4 from the line for the Tigers there. Can't leave up those empty baskets.
No.
Ashton looks to get inside, off. Darlin with the rebound, gets out running to Hurley. Hurley pulls it out. Hurley picks up the ball. Darlin. McNeil from three. Just off. That was a pretty deep three.
Yeah. Didn't really expect it.
No. Like the confidence.
Yeah.
Quinn with the steal. Quinn Casey. Gets it to Hopewell to settle the offense down and see if they can get something controlled and get it out. See, they got the lead. They got to just play controlled here.
Oh, a big shot.
Who was that? I got a phone call.
Foley.
She's playing great, man.
Oh. It's like we're both getting the same phone call or group chats calling. Don't know why they're doing that.
Must be a mistake.
Yeah.
Gillis, Chris, McNeil. Hurley inside, floater. Just off. Foley with the rebound. Foley, full court pass. What a pass. Casey just fumbles it. Casey Hopewell, cross court to
good hands.
Ashton. Tipped by Darlin.
Oh, good pass.
Valley, another dime. Oh, my God.
She's been playing good.
What a pass. Ashton with the finish, too, but she's throwing dimes everywhere.
Yeah.
Ross inside. Hurley from deep. Off. Can't get it going.
Bears need something to get going here.
Yep. Gillis, they're in a huge dry spout here.
Yeah.
When was the last time they scored, you
think? I don't know. See this. This pass here from Foley.
Pocket change, dimes everywhere. Foley, what a pass. Darlin tries to get in there. Foley tips it back out of bounds. Bears ball out to Hurley. Hurley right away, jump shot. Can't get it to go. There's a cap on the net right now for the Bears. Foley looks out, let it to Ashton. Ashton looks to get it out to Hopewell. Hopewell drives out to Foley. Foley pulls it just off. She's got the confidence. That's another thing, man. The Hansies Tigers have been all over the offensive boards there. No boxing out done by the Bears.
Another foul.
Yeah. Who's that on? Number 24.
McNeil. It was a 24. Oh.
Ross.
I only seen the four. I didn't see the two.
Ross with their third personal foul.
Quick
Hansies
three.
And bonus, too.
Yeah. Only 16 seconds left, though. You got to think the Bears all for the last shot.
Yeah, for sure. Quinn gets a second to go. McNeil, Darlin. Steal by Foley. Foley, Casey. Into Hopewell. Hopewell can't get it to go. McNeil with the rebound. 3 seconds. Casey with another steal. Falling back. Quinn, man. Tigers are all over them right now.
Yeah. Go wait in the half for the Tigers.
Yeah, for sure.
Bears got to switch something up in the halftime.
13-point lead here.
It's not over yet.
Is leading 13-7. Definitely not over.
They've been getting the looks. They just can't finish.
For sure. But it's the turnovers for both sides, but especially the Bears, costly turnovers. And the defensive boards are killing them. They're not boxing out at all.
Yeah.
Offensive boards for the Tigers all day long.
So we'll see you with second half action
for
here.
Sure.
And
something about this place brings me back, it always brings me back. This kind of love won't change. Brings me back, it always.
Start an adventure like no other and discover a path of scenic surroundings and world-class education. You don't have to go far to go far. Take your next step at Cape Breton University. Visit cbu.ca.
Discover an ocean of possibilities at Cape Breton University. Turn your diploma into a degree with over 20 programs and 60 areas of study to choose from. Explore fields such as engineering, business, and education that offer opportunities for real-world research and paid co-op work placements. Gain a world-class education and form lifelong friendships on Canada's most beautiful island. Take your next step at Cape Breton University. Visit cbu.ca.
something about this place. Brings me back, yeah, always brings me back. This kind of love won't change. Brings me back.
A world-class education is closer than you think. How far you go has nothing to do with how far you go. Launch your career closer to home. Take your next step at cbu.ca. Start an adventure like no other and discover a path of scenic surroundings and world-class education. You don't have to go far to go far. Take your next step at Cape Breton University. Visit cbu.ca.
They could have forced the 8-second violation, but didn't get all over them there.
Yeah.
Valley. Quinn.
Double
dribble.
Yeah.
Bears force a turnover and get in the bucket. Good way to start. I like the lineup they come out here with. Three bigs, two guards.
Yeah.
A little older than what they finished with the two grade 12s, but.
Yeah.
Hurley. McKinnon. McNeil.
Oh.
Looks to get inside of McDonald. Pieces by.
Should have passed it earlier. It was wide open. Just didn't. Didn't give it inside.
And off of McDonald there. I think Hopewell got pieces there and then it was went off Addison's McDonald's hands there. Couldn't get control of it. Folley. Crossover. Beats him wide. Valley.
Yeah.
Travel. Both teams need to take care of the ball. In my opinion, it's who can take care of the ball better wins this game.
Yeah.
Hurley.
11-point lead for Hants East, but still not
looks
over.
To set up their play. Tipped out by Folley. Hurley drives baseline into Burke. Burke, turnaround. Nice shot. McDonald with the follow-up.
Good defense.
Blocked?
Yeah.
Ah, good defense by Hopewell. Gatto outrunning. Thinks about it. Out to Folley. Screen. Folley from three deep. Just off. Burke with the rebound. Burke controls. Burke looks to find the guard. She takes it herself. Burke to McNeil. McNeil over the top to McKinnon. Just wasn't there. Little force.
Yeah, a little bit of force.
Valley. Bears stick with the press. Over top to Casey. Casey. Floater. Just off. Burke. Burke turns. Outlet to McNeil. Gatto with the steal. Gatto to Quinn in the corner. Quinn.
Defense.
McNeil all over. Steal by McNeil. McNeil pulls back. Foul on Case. Ooh. Gets the steal and then turns it over. Unlucky. Casey inbounds it. Valley. Into Quinn. Quinn to Fowler. Quinn, Casey, Gatto from the top of the key, just can't get it to go. McDonald with a nice strong rebound down low. McDonald out to Burke. McNeil. McNeil to the corner to Hurley. Great ball moving. Hurley drives strong. Can't get it to go. Nice strong drive there. Just couldn't finish.
Still Valley. Can't get anything to fall.
Coach Hoagie wants him to stick with this press and work.
Oh.
Who are they calling this on?
Hurley.
McNeil, I think.
Hurley.
Oh, wow.
Looked like failed.
Looked like
it
was all ball.
Yeah, but he's got a better angle than we do. So
yeah.
I trust him.
Yeah, for sure. Fowley. Fowley to Casey. Casey from the side. Nice floater from the block. Bears need to get something going here. Get them back in this game. McNeil. Just turned it over.
It's been the she's story upset for
with
the Bears.
She's been upset. She's upset with herself too there.
Yeah.
Frustrated for sure. And here's Hoagie subbing and a cop. I did get the sub in there. Fowley. Fowley looks to extend this lead. Hopewell. Hopewell. Contested by McDonald. McDonald, a nice contest. Gatto with the follow up.
Yeah.
Gatto fouled hard. By McDonald, I think. Yeah, fouls on Addison McDonald. That might be her fourth. No, her second. No, no. Someone else got. I apologize. Someone else got three fouls.
I think it's Ross.
Yeah. Honestly. And a cop subbing in for Chris McNeil. Gatto missed first. They're struggling from the line today.
Yeah, they both teams.
Yeah, for sure. Makes a second. Early. McKinnon. McKinnon to McDonald. McDonald thinks about it.
Travels.
Just loses control of the ball there.
Defense there by Casey.
Yeah. Pump fakes. Got him on the pump fake too. Just lost control. Bring it down. Fowley again looks to control the pace of this game like she's been doing all game. Over the top pass. Way to break the press. Getting the ball to the middle of the floor. Gatto from deep. Can't get the go.
Deep
McDonald.
Two.
McDonald. Deep two.
Some people will say the worst shot in basketball.
For sure. Did Tigers just force a turnover?
Oh, I think so. Another one.
Another one. Hopewell inbounds it. Fowley drives. Tries to get in the middle. Luckily didn't get turn it over. Casey tries to rip it. They call a foul there on number 9 and a cop, I think. Fowley, you can't leave her that open. Whoa. She bangs it up. Can't leave her that open.
No.
She's a shooter, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Early. Scott Lecchio entering the gym.
Good ref.
Good ref. Good guy.
New ref. It's been good.
Large beard.
Hey. He likes it, though.
Yeah. Out of bounds off the Bears. Another turnover. Hants, he's extended this lead to, is it 17?
Yeah. I think so.
Damn. Bears can't do anything right now.
No.
Lecky.
Goes straight up to the couch.
Goes to find himself a nice comfy seat.
Don't know if that's meant to happen or not, but.
8 second violation. Nice defense to turn this around. That'd be a great way to shift this energy for the Bears. Nice 8 second violation. Abby McSween seven off Emily Burke. Hurley.
Oh.
Tries to get inside of McDonald. Another turnover. Gatto tries to go end to end. Euro just can't get it to go. Hopewell with the follow up. They're all over these offensive rebounds. Gotta box out. Caught. Hurley. McDonald. She's
good.
No
shot.
Hesitation. Hits it. Nice shot from the big.
Needed Wait. That one.
That's your second three of the game.
I think so.
She can definitely stretch the floor.
Yeah. Don't Solid. Usually see her shooting a whole lot, but it's working this game.
Hopewell looks to go.
Block.
Nice block. What a back-to-back play by Addison McDonald. McSween stays the Bears ball.
Doing it on both ends.
Yes. Exactly. Hurley. Kopp. Kopp wants McDonald. McDonald. Travel.
Nope. Oh, yeah. Travel.
Bad footwork.
Thought he was calling a foul.
She got to put the ball down there, you know?
Yeah.
And she got the ball where she wanted. She's so dominant in that low post. Mm-hmm. Fowley. Looks to break press. Hopewell. Hopewell gets the ball to the middle. Kopp all over. Hopewell, cross court pass to Gatto. She's a shooter.
Oh.
Bang. They're shooting the lights out right now.
Yeah, that was a good offensive possession from the Tigers.
Nice cross court pass from Hopewell.
Yeah.
Can't leave her that open, obviously. No. Hurley drives. Floater. Can't get the go, but McDonald there? No. Fowley. Fowley looks to push. Fakes it, pump fake, Gatto.
Foul.
Oh, she almost got the and one day. That would have been insane. Gatto going to line to shoot three. Fouls on 23, Taylor Hurley.
Second foul?
Yeah. Zuku very loud over there.
Yeah, starting to get into it.
Did she get the first one to go?
There's the camera.
Gets the third one to go, and Amy Darling subbing in for taking off Ava McKinnon.
Yep.
Ava McKinnon, first sub of the half. Hurley looks to turn this game around for the Bears.
Hopefully he has some scoring.
They're down 20. They
22
need,
points.
They need a run right now if they want to stay in this game.
They just got anything to go.
Darling turns it out shot. To Hurley. Hurley from three.
Another deep two. Got to watch your feet.
Yeah. Ashton pushes. Gatto. Hopewell. Oh. Quinn subbed in for Fowley, too. Gatto with a nice mid-range pull-up. Hurley. Wants at McDonald. McDonald from the free throw line.
Good shot.
They're going to have to just feed her if they want to get back in this game.
They got to cut it down
playing
before
a great
the quarter
game.
Ends.
Bears all over them. Bears just gets it over half in time, but McDonald loses it. They force the turnover.
Yeah, just can't. Unlucky.
They just got over half in time, then they got a careless pass. McDonald just lost it. Gatto, backdoor pass to Hopewell. Hopewell can't get it to go. McDonald looks to push it. Hurley and Gatto. Hurley, one, two.
Good save.
Gets it to go. Nice finish.
Needed that one.
Yeah. Needed this.
Oh, and good,
Hurley all
good
over
shield.
Them. Nice way to get in the passing lanes. Nothing came off the shot clock there.
Nope.
Wonder who's working the clock.
Yeah, not somebody anymore. Oh.
Subs in. Fowley's coming in for Casey. I like that sub for the Tigers.
Yeah.
As soon as she went off the floor, they've been struggling to beat the press and struggling to take care of the ball. She just really controls this game as the main point guard on the floor right now.
Can't leave her open.
Gatto. Bang! Sniper.
She's killing them.
Yeah, for sure. Hurley. McSween. Inside of McDonald. Nice. Can't give it a go. Kopp with the rebound, though. Kopp to McSween. Hurley. Pull up. Blocked. Nice defense by Quinn. Tigers getting them out running again. Beat him up the floor. Gatto again off. McDonald with the rebound. McDonald outlet to Hurley. Can't get that pass. Fowley with the steal. Fowley struggles to get it off Hurley's pressure there, but gets it out of her hands, and then a travel call for Ashton. Bears ball. McSween. McSween pump fake. McSween baseline. Just off. Fowley with the rebound.
Better offense there.
Fowley looks to push it out. Fowley running the floor. Floater. Gatto with the follow-up. Gatto can't get to go. Hopewell.
Gotta go help rebound.
Quinn, another offensive rebound.
Oh, there you go.
Hurley in the passing lanes. Hurley, one.
Finish.
Gets it to go. Great, great defense by Hurley. Turning defense into offense. That's what you need to do to make a run. Hurley reaches. Fowley.
Need to cut the lead down here before the half. Got another two baskets, please.
Hopewell. McDonald gets the rebound.
Another
McDonald.
One.
What an outlet pass.
Save it.
Taylor saves it. Taylor. Foul. Blocking foul.
On the floor, though.
Foul's on number six. Sierra Fowley. Taylor Hurley draws the foul there. Look at this pass. And then another cross-court pass. And Gatto hits that three.
Bears there.
She hit a three?
No, two.
See, sorry, I got replay there. Fowley. Fowley go over the top to beat the press. Quinn. Quinn to Gatto. Gatto pump fake.
Oof. Yeah, I was going to say that
was definitely a foul. I was thinking the same thing. Two shots. Fouls on.
Late call there, but.
Addison McDonald.
Definitely the right one.
Yeah. Hard hit. Who's Emily Burke taking off here?
Addison McDonald.
Yeah, giving her the 30-second break and get her back on, hopefully, in the fourth quarter.
Yep.
Gatto gets it to go. Bears went on a little run here, but I think they need it more to get back in this game.
Yeah.
There's Cole McDonald with the cymbals.
It's not working, though.
Nope.
Gatto, ice cold on the free throw line. Hurley, coast
drive.
To coast. What a take. Hurley, end to end, just splits the defense, taking this game over by herself.
Need to stop here.
Ashton, you need this. Yes, exactly. Gatto, can't leave her that open.
Oh, lucky there.
Burke with the rebound. Hurley. 17-point game, is it? Yeah.
Better quarter from there from the Bears. Got some more scoring.
Last 5 minutes was great.
Yeah.
But not enough, I don't think.
No. It's they got to keep cutting it down.
Yeah.
They're playing good towards the end of the quarter. I think they cut it down 5-6 points.
It's just
they can't get stops.
It's the turnovers. Turnovers. There's Taylor Hurley. Look. Split this.
Oh, yeah, good take there.
What a take. Splits the defense and finishes high. Yeah, it's one of those things where you can't take care of the ball. You're not going to win the game.
Yeah.
And their defense, they're not been getting any. They're leaving Gatto and Fowley way too open from the three-point line. They got to realize they're two snipers.
Yeah. And then the Bears themselves need to start hitting some more threes.
For sure. Coach Hoagie down there.
Talking it over.
Yeah.
See here, just another layup from Hurley.
Another angle. It was a good quarter, though, from both teams. I think if the Bears want any chance of winning this game, they got to make an early run.
Yeah, 100%.
Very early run. And all the Tigers really have to do is just
keep coming down and scoring, and get some stops on defense.
Controlling the ball, I think, too.
Turnovers is going to kill them.
Turnovers.
If they keep turning it over, then they're just going to dig themselves in the hole that they don't need to.
The Bears press did work earlier, but at times Tigers were beating it and getting open layups.
Yep. But towards the end, the Tigers were just throwing the ball away recklessly.
They looked tired.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Got to hope they can fix that.
They need to get the ball back to Fowley and let her run the offense.
Yeah.
For sure. Bears start with the ball here. Hurley looks to set up the offense here and get a bucket right away for the Bears. Hurley looks left to that. Another turnover.
Good recovery, though.
Yes, good recovery. Way to get back on defense. They don't always get back on defense.
No.
Hurley with the steal. Hurley looking for someone to move. McSween inside. Gets fouled. Hopewell, number seven. Corey Hopewell with the foul there. Hit to the arm. Chris McNeil subbing in here for...
Shooter.
Not sure who it is.
The shooter.
Shooter, okay. So I have McSween and Pedros is also subbing in, but... for some reason, they didn't sub her in before the free throws.
Because she was taking the shot.
No, but there's another sub.
Oh, yeah, true.
Sweet gets the first to go. Air ball? Must have slipped.
Yeah.
There, you can't make the first and then air ball. Yeah. It must have slipped.
Yeah.
Pedro was taking off Addison Darlington.
Might have been something in the air, too. You never know.
Yeah, she's laughing.
A bit of wind in here.
She's smiling. Quinn, middle of the floor. Fowley. Fowley loses it, gets it back. Face. Casey.
Oh, good defense.
This is not what the Tigers want right now at all. They got to take care of the ball if they want to keep this
They're
lead.
They're just doing it to themselves.
Yeah, for sure. They can't let the Bears get back in this game if they wanted this. Hurley. Ross. Burke, nice feed.
Good
Burke
take.
With the take. This is Bears cutting it down to 14.
Yeah.
Making this
there.
A game. This is great.
Good
McNeil
defense.
With another steal. Bears nice. Hurley all the way. Gets it to go. This is
making it a game.
Defense to offense. This is what you
there.
Need to do. Bears look to trap. Bears. And a cop all over. And a cop with a steal.
Oh,
football. Unlucky.
Good defense, though. Good
defense.
Intensity
this
from
is
Bears.
Great intensity. This is exactly what you need.
Yeah.
And I find everything feeds off defensive intensity.
So far.
Players who can bring that intensity really help teams, you know?
Yeah.
That's exactly what Anna Kopp, Taylor Hurley, and Chris McNeil are doing right now. Gatto inside. Can't
defense.
Get to go. Burke with the rebound. Burke.
Got to get it
looks
over.
Looks to get it to McNeil. McNeil. Got to get it over half. Gets it over half. McNeil. That's not what you
could
want at all. And Gatto gets out running. Catches them sleeping. And she gets that to go.
Yeah.
Gets it back to a 14-point lead. Ross bringing the ball up the floor here. McNeil. Gets inside to Burke. Burke, down low to Ross.
Travel?
Nah.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't see it.
I don't got a good angle, so no. I don't know. She had perfect position, though.
Yeah.
Messed that one up. Good feed by Burke.
Yep. Playing better so far this
yeah,
quarter.
Yeah, for sure. Fowley. Hoagie not happy with
no.
Burke.
Got lucky there.
Yeah. McNeil. Crossover.
Good handle.
Yeah. Burke. Turns. Corner. Not there. It was there earlier and Hurley
yeah.
was calling for it, so Burke thought she was still open.
Yeah.
And Hopewell got over in the lane. Hopewell and Gatto are both long frames who really do
yeah.
well getting in the passing lanes.
They've been two of their better players
yeah,
so far.
Yeah, for sure. Hurley brings it back out.
Another steal. Good
McNeil
recovery.
Didn't give up, though. Out to Burke.
Oh.
Burke from deep just off. That looked like it was on line.
Would have been a big shot.
Green ball.
It was a pretty little play there. I didn't really know what was going on.
Yeah.
Tangled up
neither.
In the corner.
At all.
Timeout here.
Bears forced a timeout here. Come out.
Good work so far from the
come
Bears.
Out working. And it was that play there. Hurley just great getting out running.
Yeah.
She's doing a great job. She's
been like that all season.
One of the fastest
yeah.
players on the floor. She knows she can go end-to-end with it.
Luke McKinnon making up a bit of beat here, it looks like.
Luke McKinnon over there.
He's not very good.
No,
no
I don't find either. He's laughing up.
He tried to do something, but that's just not him.
No, they should get Derek Laura on the drums.
Yeah, yeah, I don't know why they don't.
Oh, what's going on here?
Oh,
the refs. Oh. There you go. See that last
up.
Play there. Hurley looked to get into McNeil, and McNeil is like, she's a great ball player, but height-wise,
yeah.
why do you want the ball there
no,
in the paint?
No, I'm not gonna do much what you get
no,
there.
No, for sure you're gonna get the ball, and she has to finish over two
yeah,
tall players.
Putting her in a bad position.
But she did turn over the ball, but she did get the ball. She didn't give up.
Yep.
And got the ball back, and then Bears have the ball in the corner. Look at this. Hurley, another angle that play earlier where she just splits the D. Bears come out the same lineup. I think the Tigers do too.
Yep.
And
good lineup here from the Bears.
Travel. just poor footwork there when she first got the ball. Happens though. A lot of guys I play with do that a lot.
Yeah. Dribbles off her knee there.
Off her knee. Bears force a turnover. Yeah. Bears playing great defense right
good
now.
Defense.
They just need to get their offense going. They get their offense going. They're back in this game. Seven. A lot of times left, and they're only down 14.
Yep.
Hurley. Into Ross. Ross to
another
Burke.
Good pass.
That is awesome. That.
Ran that play twice so far. Pretty to watch.
Burke with a nice finish.
Good steal.
Hurley.
Still skip pass. Trapped in the corner.
McNeil. Jump ball.
Tigers ball.
Yeah.
The press from the Bears here so far.
Yeah, it's definitely working way better in this fourth quarter.
Yeah.
They're doing something right.
12-point lead for Hants.
And the Tigers got a short bench, obviously. That looked like a travel. Tigers, another forced turnover. Tigers got a short bench, so they're definitely tired.
Yeah.
And a cop up to Burke, pushes the ball.
Good pass.
McNeil.
Oh,
McNeil had Ross.
Yep.
Turnover from Hurley. Valley. Hopewell.
Good poke. Travel.
Another walk from the Tigers.
Better defense.
Hoagie's practically on the floor right now, coaching up Anna Kopp over there.
Yeah.
Young rookie Anna Kopp, having a good season overall for her. Definitely.
A lot of steals so far this game.
Great defender.
Yeah.
Works hard. Hurley. Kopp to McNeil. McNeil cross court to Hurley. Hurley drives. Not there. 8 seconds on the clock. Gets it back up. They can't get the go.
Whoa.
Jump ball. Casey falls hard.
Down hard.
Girls look to help her up. Something happened there. She's hurt.
Yeah.
Just a jump ball called there. Quinn coming on for Dylan Casey. Hopefully she's okay.
It hurt.
Hopefully she's okay, you know?
Yeah, that one looked like it hurt.
Hopewell up the gaddle. What a nice play there. Fowley.
Foul. Honest, I thought they called a jump ball there. I guess they did.
No, they called a jump ball.
Should have been Bears ball. They just had the last jump ball.
Maybe. No. They switched it.
No. Because last time, remember we said they had a jump ball down there.
Oh, yeah. So it must have been a foul. Or they made their own call. Fowley at the line shooting two. McDonald comes in, says subs off Ross. Valley gets it go. 14-point game here. 6-13 left in the fourth quarter.
Need something.
Yeah, for sure.
Something magic to happen here.
McDonald inside. Over top, Carissa McNeil. Just off.
There you go. Got to be Bears ball here. There you go.
Kopp down low. Kopp to McNeil. McNeil to out to McDonald.
Gets in the
paint. McDonald gets in the paint. Floater. Nice shot.
Good finish.
She's having a great game.
Yeah, really good game.
Beck looks to keep the pressure.
Another good steal.
Another steal for McDonald. McDonald. I like that idea. That was the right pass, just not high enough. And Gatto
does
what she does best and get out running. Fowley always forcing turnovers and Gatto getting out running. McNeil into McDonald. McDonald turns, not there.
Forcing a lot.
Yeah.
5 minutes left. They got to
turn it around.
Yeah, it's got to happen now if it's going to happen. Ooh.
Fowley, nice move. Quinn. Cross court to Gatto. Gatto can't leave her that open. Can't get it to go. Fowley with the rebound. Just off. McDonald.
She's got her.
She's got it, though.
4-on-1. Yep.
Hey, I like that. Oh, wow.
There you go.
There you go. She might have got fouled there. Finished her contact.
Yeah. If they wouldn't have scored there, I would have been disappointed.
Yeah,
at a 4-on-1.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Foul here on Kopp.
But I like Hurley's decision, knowing that she goes up for that rebound, she goes up for that layup, she's got people here to rebound there.
Yeah.
You know? Smart. Quinn. Fowley falls.
Yeah.
Hopewell inside, just off. And a cop out to Hurley. Hurley.
2-1 here.
Oh, all the way.
And foul.
And one. What a take. This is huge.
Big shot.
Could turn this into a single-digit game here.
Still with 4:27 left. Big free throw here. Timeout
Hants East. Is that my favorite gym teacher I see over there?
I think so.
Yeah. Look at this. Finish through contact. Nice finish. Fouls on Fowley. Yeah.
Stuart McNeil or some who were close to him, call him Stu.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Great gym teacher.
Gym teacher. New gym teacher.
Yeah. Probably my favorite teacher in the whole school. Right?
Yeah. He's got to be one of them. As we see the Marauders on the sideline there getting ready for their next game.
Yeah. Who are they playing again? The Lynx.
Lynx should be going.
And
if you want to tune in at 5:00, we got the hometown Bears taking on South Colchester.
Yeah. Not sure how that game's gonna go, but
no, could.
Could be a good one.
Bears 3-0 so far. Last game before the semis.
Yeah. Week's been going
very
fast.
You see the Lynx.
Yep.
Getting ready for their game.
Week's been going by very fast, you know?
Yeah.
It's already Thursday. That's crazy,
eh? Yeah. But still got the two best days of the tournament coming up.
For sure. 100%.
Yep. Semis and finals.
Replay here. Early.
Good take.
I think this is the one where they missed three layups.
Three in a row.
But Addison McDonald eventually gets it.
Gets the third.
There you go.
Puts it up and in. Big free throw here from Hurley. Need to hit this.
She gets it to go. Single digit game here. 4:30 left. Bears need to keep this pressure up. Fouls on 15, Emily Burke. Valley cross court to Gatto. They love that play though.
Oh, almost got it to drop.
Valley with a rebound.
I didn't think she
jump
was,
ball.
I think she knew it was her teammate on the rebound. She went going to fight for the ball with her teammate.
They love that cross court pass, Valley and Gatto.
Yeah.
Valley up top. Valley pick and roll with Gatto. Turnover. McDonald, McNeil. Classic Cape Breton names there, McDonald and McNeil.
Yeah.
Kopp inside of Taylor. Hurley, nice pass. Law got pickpocketed. Stays Bear ball. Bears ball. Burke inbounds baseline. Kopp to Burke. Burke mid-range. Nice shot. Can't get it to go. Tigers with the rebound. Tigers on a little dry spot here, though, but they have the lead.
Yeah.
It's still comfortable, but a few more baskets, and it's a very close game. Travel
again. A lot of travels this game.
Yeah, Quinn with the travel.
Coach Hogan calling out a play. Don't know what it's going to be like.
See if they can get it going. It might be the play where they get the backdoor cut. That's exactly what it was.
Take herself. Fouled there. Not in bonus yet, so it'll just be on the sideline. But
that was the play, the one with the other big backdoor cuts. Nice play. Worked a couple times for him, for sure.
Subs in here for Hants East.
Bears haven't hit a lot of threes today.
No.
I think
McDonald's had two, and I don't know if anybody else has had any.
But the Tigers been shooting well.
Yeah, really
and
well.
And that's what's hurting them.
Good shot there. We can get it down to 7 here.
Yeah, it's a very close one, so it wasn't. Yeah. It was a shooting foul.
Still 3 minutes left. It was, I guess.
Called it on the Gavin.
Yeah.
She hits both.
Big
she
shots.
Is on fire right now.
Good game for him. Her. Need to stop here.
Yeah, this is huge possession. That's a pass you wanted. McNeil with the seal.
Like
that could have been a foul. McDonald squeezes, controls. Hurley.
Oh, I thought she was going to shoot that. Charge there, yep.
Block.
Oh, he called the block.
Wow. Looked like Tyler Mason wanted to call a charge. But down low, Nick Moroz calls the block and one.
It's
It's not his call.
This has turned into a close game here. Yeah. 5-point game. It could get it down to four here.
Yeah. Big shot here.
Wow. This is huge.
Did not look like I'll be not unbiased opinion. I thought that was a charge.
You did?
Yeah.
See,
I did not think
it's one of those calls where it could go either way because she euroed and it was more hip to hip. But I agree. It was definitely, she was there set and she was out of the.
It looks like, I think it's Bears ball. Yeah, Bears ball.
Stays Bears. 5-point game.
Get it to a one possession game here.
Wow. Coach Hoagie wants a timeout to talk this over. 3 minutes left, 55-50. Bears have crawled out of their hole. Down 20 in the second half.
Yeah, guys, I think they're drawing up a play.
Yeah. Just great. Didn't give up.
Yeah.
You see, look at this. I want to see this because this is the take.
Yeah.
She was there, but it was hip to hip.
Could have went either way.
It could have went either way.
See him calling it the whole time.
Yeah, he called that first for sure.
Yeah. It's good to see Casey back in after that hard
fall.
Yeah,
yes, exactly. Yeah. I agree. But yeah, it was either way it could go for sure.
Yeah.
This is definitely a nail biter here. 3 minutes left. Anything can go.
Turned into a good one.
For sure.
20-point game at one point, but it's turned into a good game.
Yeah, the Bears have really – it was them limiting their turnovers and forcing the Tigers with half turnovers. And feeding their bigs, too.
Yep.
And Hurley obviously getting out running.
There's another and one.
She's playing great. Hurley and McDonald have just been dominating all game long, offensively and defensively.
Mm-hmm.
Bears, I assume, are sticking with the same lineup. Yes.
Yeah.
Letting this young Anna Kopp come in and just fight for her minutes. It's not about who starts the game always, it's about who finishes the game, you know?
Yep.
That's a big thing that a lot of players have to understand. It's finishing the game is more important than starting the game, you know what I mean? McDonald inbounds baseline. Hurley from
blocked.
Three. It's blocked. What a defensive play by Gatto.
Yeah.
Gatto's out running, but Kopp realizes.
Yeah.
Fouling.
Oh, good pass.
What a pass.
Can't get it to go.
Can't get it to go. Ashton with the follow-up. Can't
good
get
range.
It to go. Gatto.
Good shot.
Gets it to go. Fouley waited till the perfect time to make that pass. So waited till the other defender to pull up and dropped it off.
Still
nice pass.
A lot of time here left for the Bears. 250. Shot there. Oh.
Ah. McDonald, I like that though. Fouls on, I'm assuming, Anna Kopp.
Yeah. Still not in bonus. Both teams one foul away from bonus. That's five fouls on Kopp.
Five fouls, she fouled out.
Yeah, just too aggressive on the press.
She played a great game, that's a great nine.
Game,
big
great
minutes.
Game.
McKinnon's coming on now. Ava McKinnon, great 12.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully she can turn it up, you know? Fouling. From deep.
Oh my God. What a shot. It's a big shot.
Made a 10-point game. Jeez, what a shot.
Might have put that one away.
A lot of time left, but that was huge. That was definitely huge.
The Bears are going to need an answer here.
Hurley.
That's not what
not
you
want. Not what you
want.
Fouley. Way to get back by McNeil. Ava McKinnon all the way up.
The pass.
Hurley. Gets the finish. 8-point game here.
Need a stop here.
Bears need a stop.
Oh, they had it.
They get it up. Gatto. McDonald one-on-one.
Good defense.
Good defense. McDonald with the stop. McKinnon. Bounce pass. McDonald. Nice. Out of control.
Yeah.
You got to take care of the ball in these late times of the game.
I need a stop.
Tigers.
Need another stop here.
Ashton looks to slow down the game.
Yep.
Set up a play. Use the whole shot clock, you know.
Almost had that one.
It's close. Risky pass there, Fouley. McNeil, you need to push the ball.
Yep.
McKinnon.
That 3-on-1 gives it to Hurley.
Hurley.
Looked like a foul there, too.
Oh, man. 6-point game. Hurley, another bucket.
I wouldn't have been surprised if they
dominated.
Gave her an A1 there.
Oh, travel.
Oh,
McNeil.
Good defense there from McNeil.
Did that not look like a travel? I'm not trying to be biased.
I'm
sorry to all Hansies Tigers fans out there. That looked like a travel, but Tigers ball. Fouley, she's been playing a great game.
Yeah.
I'd say feed her, but.
Minute left here.
Hopewell.
Need to stop.
Ashton. Gatto, Fouley, can't leave her that open.
Two.
McNeil, rebound, you gotta get it up. 6-point game. McDonald, you gotta rush.
Good skip.
Hurley.
Looks like another foul.
Another finish.
Surprised they're not giving it.
Hants East wants a timeout. 4-point game here. Another turnaround. Beck digs himself out another hole. Goes down 10 after having a couple turnovers, but Hurley comes out, steps up. 6 points in a row.
It's been all her this quarter.
All her.
Look, I honestly think that could have been an N1. And the other one.
And the other
one. The two of them.
For sure. Like, just reaches, you know?
Here you can see Coach Hogan.
I'm assuming just talking over the press.
On the press. Yeah, 100%.
Maybe switching up the press from earlier.
Here's the other take. That's, another foul. That's what I'm saying. They both could have. It could be a 2-point game right
could
now.
Could be a 2-point game for sure.
But, you know, I think the refs knew. I think he knew he messed up that charge call. Yeah. And he was giving,
maybe
him,
it was a
he
turn.
Was giving him a call.
Maybe. Yeah. Never know. They've definitely been doing a great job today.
Good overall. So far. But, no, I think 14 fouls on only one foul to give for both teams, you know.
And Tigers look a little tired.
Yeah.
Tigers look tired. So
I think they're going to give it to Foley and Hope. I don't think.
You got to give it to her. She's been playing wicked. That deep three there was, that was deep.
And just hope she can beat the press herself.
For
but
sure.
If not, then the Bears, they got a good chance to come back here if they can get
they
a steal
can't
right
let,
off of that.
They can't let them.
No, they can't let Gatto get out.
Yeah. And that's what's been happening all day. Yeah. I assume Hansi's going to advance.
Yeah.
And
that's definitely what Coach Hogan was talking about.
But
not letting
when they're pressing
the
later, they can't let Gatto get the ball over the top, too, from Fowley. That's what they've been getting all day.
Yeah. They need a steal here.
Bears coming to man-to-man. Got to put pressure on. That's what you wanted, honestly. You want it. That's a bad shot. Got to box out. Got to box out. McKinnon.
Good finish, though.
Got to rush.
Roll at the top of the backboard.
Yeah.
Dropping.
Nice finish by Ashton.
Need a three here.
Steps McDonald it. Pulls it.
Oh, couldn't get the drop.
McKinnon with the rebound, though.
Their ball.
Bears
still
ball.
Got a chance
25
here.
Seconds left.
Need a three. 100%. 14 seconds on the shot clock. 25 seconds in the game.
Tigers switch it. McKinnon.
Can't get it to drop.
That looks like game, fell.
Yeah, it looks like it might be
it. Not much they can do now.
Yeah.
It's a great game.
Gotta put the Tigers in bonus.
I don't understand why they wouldn't foul them earlier, but.
No, but it's okay.
It's okay.
It's not over till
the final whistle, obviously, the final buzzer, but I think the Bears should be proud of their performance and the Tigers obviously play a great game. Fowley can't get a go, but
you know, if they can get a rebound here, get out in transition, they can. You know, you never know.
Yeah.
You never know.
Fowley,
anything can happen.
Fowley's definitely played a great game, though. Eh?
Played with the game, I'd say.
My opinion, too.
Big shot there. That's
and I'd say Hurley would be player of the game for the Bears. But McDonald played a great game, too. But Hurley just took over the game in the second half.
Timeout here from
Made
Hogan.
It a game. It was a 20-point game. She came on, just turned it up. And
Hogan's got a... Looks. I guess he's still got belief.
He's still got belief, obviously.
What you want with your coach.
For sure.
You know, I think if they need anything, they need a quick three, a steal, and two, and just two back-to-back steals off the inbounds. And that'd be a miracle if that would ever happen. But it's not been a great shooting game for them either, so you never know what could happen.
Yeah, here's the replay.
Just need a box out. High off the glass.
Ash in there. Ogie talking over. Probably drawn up a play to get a three, honestly.
Yeah, I'd say they give it to McDonald, personally.
McDonald or Hurley. McDonald's been
their shooter so far this game. Tigers just got to – they just
– got to take care of the ball.
One defensive possession in this thing, and they win. That's all it is.
And I'd say – I personally think stay aggressive defensively.
Yeah.
No reason to back off and give them an open shot. All right, rest are now waiting for the Bears to come on the floor.
Yeah. See if they can work some magic here. Need a miracle. Looks like it's not going to be for McDonald, but just get the ball to Hurley.
Oh, it is for
McDonald.
I like that. What a play.
Big shot.
Big shot.
You never know.
Nine seconds.
What can happen.
Foul. Hoagie.
Screaming.
I was screaming too, but Hoagie was on the floor screaming. That was obvious. McNeil's got to be more aware.
Yeah, but still 5 seconds left.
Wasted four seconds.
Ogie's got a timeout. Still got a timeout.
Point game though.
So nice. She misses both. Got a timeout. Get
but
up.
But I don't think she's missing both. Valley's a knockdown.
I don't think so. Big shot.
Yeah, she's ice
cold.
Shot
there.
She's ice cold, man.
Can't call a timeout now either if she misses.
Yeah. Doesn't get to go.
That's
game.
That is the game.
Hey, finish a good game. You
strong game so from both teams. You know, made it a game.
Bears came back from a 20-point hole, but Valley just took over the game at the end with that D3. Yeah. Made those free throws and iced the game.
Can't do much about it. It's a great game both ways, though. I'd say player of the game for the Bears is probably Hurley. And Tigers,
Valley.
I think you got to give it to Valley. Might not have the most points, but I think Adam might have scored the most. But
good week for both girls, you know?
Yeah. Both teams.
Good week for
both
girls.
Seems like they had fun.
Yeah. That's
and,
for sure.
Well, we'll see you, hopefully, at 5 o'clock here in the gym for the Bears game.
Don't forget about the Memorial Lynx game.
No.
See how that one goes. All right.
Yeah. All right, and we'll see you.
See you later.
Yep.
Discover an ocean of possibilities at Cape Breton University. Turn your diploma into a degree with over 20 programs and 60 areas of study to choose from. Explore fields such as engineering, business, and education that offer opportunities for real-world research and paid co-op work placements. Gain a world-class education and form lifelong friendships on Canada's most beautiful island. Take your next step at Cape Breton University. Visit cbu.ca.
An adventure like no other and discover a path of scenic surroundings and world-class education. You don't have to go far to go far. Take your next step at Cape Breton University. Visit cbu.ca.